The world position offset input allows a material to manipulate the vertices of a mesh in world space. This is useful for making objects move, change shape, rotate, and a variety of other effects. World position offset is often used for subtle, ambient animation. The above network causes the sphere to grow and shrink along its vertex normals with a sinusoidal period of 1 second. When using world position offset to expand your object beyond its original bounds, keep in mind that the renderer still uses those original bounds. This means that you may see culling and shadowing errors. You may go into the properties of a mesh and set its scale bounds property to compensate, though this has a draw on performance and may lead to shadowing errors. The world position offset category contains special functions for applying manipulating vertices of a mesh via world position offset. These functions can be chained together for additive effects. The following is a list of all the functions underneath the world position offset category. The simple grass wind function applies a basic wind operator to foliage, giving the ability to specify a weight map and wind strength. This is a non-directional wind that just gives a very general movement to foliage. This should be the last WPO node you add. The spline thicken function serves as a way to make very thin polygons look thicker at render time. This is perfect for cables, hair, grass, and other such objects. Objects using this function should be extremely thin and should be imported with remove degenerate triangles disabled. The camera offset function is great to assist with depth sorting, as it allows you to move an object in camera space, either toward or away from the camera. The object pivot point function returns the object's pivot point in world space. This is not compatible with the pixel shader. The object scale function returns the object's XYZ scale together and separately. This is not compatible with the pixel shader. The pivot axis function creates a common pivot location on arbitrary axes. This is helpful for creating flag motion. Instead of using a single pivot point near the top of the flag, use a shared Z point and unique X and Y location data to create a more realistic connection along the object's width. The rotate about world axis underscore cheap function cheaply rotates objects around world axes. Input the angle you would like to use and attach the output to world position offset. The static mesh morph targets function unpacks morph target data that was added into a via 3ds max's morph packer max script. The wind function provides separate outputs for wind strength, speed multiplied by time, and a normalized wind vector. Hope from this video, you will start to move into building in more advanced mechanics, in an easy to follow step-by-step approach, which will allow you to play around and build your own content, to eventually build your own game. Thanks a lot, see you in the next video.